Здравствуйте, уважаемые подписчики.
Good afternoon, dear subscribers and guests of the channel. All technologies shown in this video are based on the use of nichrome wire. Some of them are probably familiar to you, and some may surprise you. Enjoy your viewing. The nichrome wire tensioning unit of this machine is assembled on the basis of a sliding bearing. This assembly design allows a more compact machine to be built. To secure the wire, I drilled holes and cut the thread in the screw's hex heads. The wire is tensioned by a spring. For cutting styrofoam and polyethylene terephthalate bottles, a nichrome wire with a diameter from 3/10 to 4/10 of a millimeter can be used. To build a vertical cutting machine, I used a channel and two pieces of duralumin pipe. I secured these parts with two threaded rods. To tension the wire, I used the same pivot assembly as in the horizontal cutting machine. To securely fix the heated nichrome wire from the side of the bed plate, I fixed a steel eyelet at the bottom of the bed plate, through which I passed the nichrome wire. Coins soldered to the screw heads allow you not to use a screwdriver. To demonstrate the work of the machine, I will show how you can use it to make a volumetric logo from styrofoam. There seems to be nothing special to explain. And this is a very simple machine for bending plexiglass and other plastic sheets. Here too, a spring is used to compensate for the change in the length of the nichrome wire as a result of heating. It takes a lot of energy to heat thick sheet materials. Therefore, I used a nichrome wire with a diameter of 1 millimeter and passed a current of 20 amperes through it. To ensure the desired bending angle, the workpiece should be clamped in a template and held until the plastic hardens. This machine uses two nichrome wires with a diameter of 3/10 and 4/10 of a millimeter, which are connected in parallel to a power source. Each wire is tensioned with a separate spring. A thinner wire is located closer to the axis of rotation. To simplify the design of the nichrome string attachment points, the side strips are insulated from each other using a glass fiber laminate plate. Due to the fact that the axis of rotation of the nichrome strings coincides with the edge of the bed plate, the task of adjusting the position of each string is simplified. The position of the thin string is determined by the diameter of the pipe to be insulated, and the position of the thick string determines the outer dimension of the insulation. Foam insulation, unlike some other porous materials, can even be installed on wet pipes. And this is the simplest tool that allows you to weld plastic bags with one movement of your hand. Two screws secure a small piece of nichrome wire with a diameter of 0.4 mm. To reduce friction between this tool and the plastic bag, fluoroplastic tapes are used. Two more layers of fiberglass protect each sponge rubber cushion from overheating. I have used this tool in the past for packaging small batch products. And this tool makes it easy to remove double insulation from the ends of conductors. This method can also be used to remove fluoroplastic insulation, but I would not risk doing it at home because of the high toxicity of overheated fluoroplastic. At the factory, special fume hoods are used for this purpose. With a conventional drill, you can easily wind up heating elements, for example for an infrared soldering station. You can use a wooden clothespin to protect your hands. It is imperative to stretch the heater to avoid turn-to-turn short circuits. I left a few turns on the left on purpose to demonstrate this. With the help of a nichrome wire, you can cut glass pipes or, for example, turn bottles into glasses. The heating time of the glass is selected experimentally. It depends on the thickness of the glass and the diameter of the nichrome wire. Just one drop of water is enough to complete the process. Of course, the cut will have to be sanded to avoid cuts. Now I will show you how you can make a reliable and safe USB heating pad. You can use a cotton cloth for the heating element, but I chose a linen cloth so that, if necessary, you can connect the heating pad to a more powerful power source than the USB 3 standard allows. First, I sewed the grooves for laying the nichrome wire. And then he inserted four wires with a diameter of 0.4 mm into these grooves using a homemade needle. You can make this needle from a bicycle knitting needle. The resistance of four wires connected in parallel is equal to 2.7 ohm. The power of the heater, at a voltage of 5 volts and a current of 1.9 ampere, is 9 watts. These parameters allow you to connect the heating pad to the USB interface 3. When the heater is powered with a voltage of 5.2 volts, the current consumption increases to 2 amperes, and the power of the heater to 10 watts. In case of connecting the heating pad to a more powerful power source, for example, for heating coffee, an 80 degrees Celsius thermal switch was installed in the heating pad, which I removed from the faulty laptop battery. This compact heating pad can be used to warm up baby food. At home, the heating pad can be connected to a standard charger rated for 1.9 ampere or more, or to any free USB port 3 version on your computer. But to heat coffee, you need a 10-12 volt source and an adapter. Outside the home, this heating pad can be connected to a mobile power bank. And finally, the heating pad can be used for its intended purpose by attaching it to the sore spot. This is a working model of a microlift for a turntable. In real products, nichrome wire is placed horizontally, but this does not change the principle of operation. An electric current flowing through a nichrome wire heats the latter and its length increases. By varying the amperage, you can set the required speed of lowering the needle onto the plate. A nichrome wire with a diameter of 0.2 mm was used in the layout. Using pliers and a hammer, you can make any shape for a wood-burning pen tip. I made a pen tip suitable for burning thick lines using a 1.2 mm nichrome wire. A link to the manufacturer of the remaining parts of this device is in the description of the video. If a screw breaks off in a concrete wall, then it can be removed from there without damaging the hole. To demonstrate this method, I had to break one such screw. To remove the broken screw, we will use the wood-burning pen from the previous plot, but with a feather slightly longer than the length of the broken screw. After a few minutes, the plastic plug will melt and the screw can be easily removed from the hole. Small plastic parts can be joined by welding using a heated nichrome wire. The main thing in this case is to ensure the fixation of the parts to be welded relative to each other, as well as their joint movement relative to the heated wire. This episode shows the process of making valves from disposable syringes. A link to a video about these valves and the pump for which they were made is in the video description. And this is a relatively safe way to extract mercury from glass devices. It is good because the mercury under the water layer does not evaporate. However, you should not remove mercury from devices unless you are qualified to carry out this process, which is hazardous to health and the environment. Subscribe to the channel if you liked the video. See you on the channel.